I will talk about the current changes in Japanese socioeconomic conditions surrounding young people. And I also emphasize the importance of some political change or change of political attitude among young people in Japan. Let's start. Now we watch primary elections in U.S. presidential race in both parties, and I can find some resurgence of idealism in the United States, especially in the side of the Democratic Party. A lot of young people join a campaign for Senator Sanders, and he proposes social democratic agenda such as the free university education and universal healthcare system. I think the young people in Anglo-Saxon countries are fed up with the so-called neoliberal economic policies, and they try to pursue different values from wealth or prosperity. I think these trends among young people in UK and United States have something to do with the current change in Japan. Before talking about the current situation in Japan, I'd like to explain what happened in Japan, especially Japanese economy and society in the past 20 years. The so-called bubble economy burst in the early 1990s, and the Japanese economy has been stagnant for more than two decades. And we also find a drastic change of the world of jobs or employment. We find a rapid increase of irregular jobs since the 1990s, and also gap between haves and have-nots has been becoming wider, and we are worried about the widespread poverty among children and young people. Let me see some data. These figures show the change of GDP in Japan. So GDP remains almost the same since the middle of 1990s. And this figure shows the change of corporate profit, red line, and wages, blue line, for past 20 years. And since the start of 21st century, the correlation between corporate profit and wages turned from a positive to negative. So corporate earns a lot of profit, and at the same time, wages decrease. And this figure shows decrease of relative poverty. So in Japan, almost one out of six people are poor condition. That is the one of the worst in OECD countries, second to United States. This is the United States, and this is Japan. And some scholars analyze that the aging population causes poverty. But when we look at increase of poverty by age, we can find increase of age in younger generation. And this is due to the increase of irregular workers and spread of low wages jobs. And this figure shows the number of births in Japan. There was a big baby boom just after the Second World War and the early 70s, the second baby boom. And those who were born in the middle of 1970s or the second baby boom became the reached the age of marriages in the middle of 1990s, but there was no third baby boom in Japan. Why? Because young people who are not able to make families because, you know, they were not able to find stable jobs with good salary. And I must say, Japan failed to keep sustainability of society, and because of the lack of the third baby boom, the population of Japan started to decline around 2008 or 9. And you know, this change of Japan's economic structure also causes the change of higher education. The government emphasizes that the university education should be an investment, and also they emphasize useful knowledge education in universities. But at the same time, I can find some cultural transformation among young people. The government started a new program called Utori, or post-entrance competition education, about 15 years ago. So we can find appearance of new generation. Last year, we had a big political campaign against a new security bill promoted by the Abe administration. And a lot of students joined a movement against the security bill. That was the first students' movement since 1970. The most famous organization is SEAS, or Students' Emergent Action for Liberal Democracies. They made a big demonstration just in front of the National Diet building quite often. And this movement pulled widespread attention, not only political news media, but also ordinary people. And I talked with members of SEAS, and I found a quite interesting common feature among these people, young students. They had experience of 3/11, or the big great earthquake in Eastern Japan when they were junior high school or high school students. And they have a very gentle heart. They are very kind to people in hardship. But at the same time, they have a critical point of view about Japanese adults' irresponsibility. Or selfishness. You know, the Fukushima disaster showed how Japanese administrative or economic elites pursued profits without paying enough attention to safety of the nuclear power plant. So these young people are skeptical about the Japanese policymakers and managers. And these students become politicized at the time of the security bill legislation. I can call these students counter elites in young generation. And this year, I think this year is very important year for Japanese political history, because we have electoral reform, and suffrage age is lowered to 18 years old. After the Second World War, Japan started universal suffrage, and suffrage age was set to 20 years old. But this year, it is lowered by 2 years. And we will have upper house election in this July. So political parties pay more attention to what young people demand to politics. But Ministry of Education tries to put restraint on high school students' political activities. So I think the Japanese politicians and bureaucrats have some real opinion, honne, that they don't want young people to take interest in politics. But we can't stop young people from being indifferent to politics. Because we have a lot of problems in Japan, and especially a lot of contradiction or a lot of burden put on to shoulder of Japanese young people. We have so what will be discussed in the coming upper house election? One of the most important issue is the constitution. The Abe administration is proposing to amend the constitution, especially Article 9, which denounces war. Opposition parties and citizens are organizing movements against the constitutional amendment. And a lot of young people also join this kind of activities. It is quite interesting that the after the end of post-war prosperity, Japanese young people, especially students, take interest in politics. I think the stable world ended, or you know, they can't expect a stable life after graduating universities. They must reform Japanese society in order to make their living lives better. So I think the influence of young people in Japan will increase in this context. So thank you very much.
Thank you. So I have two questions. One is, how much influence do people actually have over the political decisions in Japan?
Of course, we have the free election and the multi-party system. In Japan, the turnout rate is becoming very low. In the last two national elections, turnout rate was just 50%. So a lot of people are indifferent to elections. And because of this indifference, strongly organized groups have bigger influence on policy making. So in order to become more influential, people, especially young people, should participate in politics. Turnout rate among 20s is, you know, less than 40%. Only you know, one third of young people go. So they must, you know, change this indifference.
And what are the possible changes on the horizon that this new voting policy could bring?
In Japan, you know, a political discussion is restrained in high school, and you know, people over 18 years old are now eligible to vote, and so they have sovereign power. So I expect, you know, this electoral reform will give more opportunities to Japanese students. And I think the young people have a lot of information through internet or other, you know, network. And there are also some civic activities to provide enough information or you know, viewpoint to these young people. So I expect you know, the more and more young people will take interest in politics.
Thank you so much.